What's going on YouTube? I am Sick Flows back here with another one. Today I'm gonna be watching this or listening to the Lil Dicky Russell Westbrook on a farm. Some of you guys kept suggesting this video. What's going on YouTube? I am back with another one. This time I'm gonna be listening to a song by Lil Dicky that you guys keep suggesting, and it is called Russell Westbrook on a Farm. So I guess that he raps over the pound cake instrumental that Drake did. So I'm definitely gonna be excited. I'm definitely excited to listen to it because I fuck with pound cake instrumental, man. With that said, guys, let's go ahead and get right into it. Thank you guys so much for all the love and support you guys are showing me. Let's go ahead and do a hashtag pound cake down in the comments right now, and let's go ahead and do this thing, boy. It's kind of weird, the picture, how he's looking at his eyes, but okay. Yeah. I hope Lil Dicky kills him, man, because this beat is fire.
Okay. Ain't no doubt about it, shit is coming. And I'm just praying that Lil Dicky love it. Always told myself that this the type of shit I wanted. I was being honest, even made a promise. Not with anybody else, this was in the conscience. Talking to my fucking self, that's a little bonkers. I know, I still got a lot of shit to conquer. I hope, that ain't even my concern though. You know I'll be working till I get what I deserve. Whatever totems I get personally, you know I'ma earn those. This ain't even about some shit up on a checklist. This about the fact that I'm about to test this. I'm about to figure out what my best is. I can't avoid it because now your boy invested. And I ain't got a choice except to smile and accept it. Pretty reckless, pretty restless, cause I've lived my life expecting love to come the second my attempt was done. And yeah, I guess to some extent I was correct because I'm getting buzzed, but now I'm about to be ubiquitous. Look it up, yeah, or that's at least what I'm assuming. But as alluded to, reality is looming, and now your dude about to make a move and take the truth and hope to God that when he threw that what he thought about is proven. But honestly, I'm not afraid that it's delusion. I'm hot enough to where I know it's not illusion. But obviously, I've been finding this confusing. This ain't even close to what I thought I would be doing. Don't get me wrong, I was born to be big, but I always figured it would be the comedy thing. So I started rapping just to see what drama it brings. But big dogs from sitcoms would holler at me. And as the time passed, I rhymed fast, the lines crafted was high class as I master my crafting. God damn, who'd have thought it'd get like this? Back in 2010, music wouldn't make that list. I'm talking top 5 to 10 strengths with no wings. I would not lie, my pen dry with no ink, or that's at least what I thought till I clawed and scratched a pen till I saw a line draw. Then I could have let bygones be bygones, but I really wanted to rhyme till my line drawn. Like, where the fuck is my peak at? Not brown, but I make it pop, then I beat that. Not crowned yet, but I don't think I decreed that. Not loud, but you know I'm ready to tweet that. I just really hope I'm ready to be that. Now you see him where D's at. Cause even though I'm softer than the tissue, I ain't nothing to sneeze at. I'm smarter, where the fuck your degrees at? And I ain't harder, but I'm hotter, homie, where the fuck your degrees at? I'm about to come in and desaturate the sheet rap today and evaporate the feedback I hate, I elaborate. At a later date, but I'm getting off the point with the player hate. What the fuck was I saying? I'm kind of a slave to my ambition. I ain't quitting till my shit is appraised. And I admit it, I predicted where I finish is crazy. But that just means that it's further away. So, bird about to work until he turn in his grave. It's really burdensome when earning something's fun for the day. But I'm concerned about the burning out from up in the stakes. I'm always up in the stakes. I'm taking dinner meetings in New York, always up for the stakes. We exploring the discussion, the great. They assuring me that when I'm more elite, I'll be secure and amazed. But this isn't insecurity, man. Like, this the opposite of that. Confidence and fact. My biggest problem is I can't honestly relax. Because inside of me a damn odyssey and axe. And I made a promise that I can't be the body to stop and think I need a lobotomy. Little Dicky the prophecy. Little bit of anomaly. Not a commodity. Not a facade. Or a lot of the comedy. Prodigies commonly brought up with Dicky. Feeling weird, let me think of an analogy. Just imagine for a second, what if Russell Westbrook never knew his own mentality? Grew up on a farm where the biggest commonality was people that conformed to the ruralist localities. To Russell, though, it was nothing but normality. And he really nice up on the plow in actuality. Everybody liked the kid and dug his personality. And so the mutuality was somewhat rationality. So then your man made a plan of practicality.
Not even a plan, it was more of a formality.
Get a little land and attend to his vitality, then raise a little family. am till it all became finality. The strategy was just to stay in the course and do your chores. When you're happy, you ain't need to abort. Never explored nothing unless he roll around on his horse.
Okay.
The one day he was up on his horse, that's when he went past the porch. The path he normally passes forth was fast and short. Was after more, went faster north. A master lord, a master more. And then discovered the court.
Oh my god. Yeah. Yeah.
Let me count him. Hopped off looking puzzled at the round rim. Saw a ball up in the corner on the ground. Then Russell started dribbling and giggling, astounded. Then he shot a brick and then a brick and then he downed it. And when he hit it, Russell listened to the fucking sound friction up in the swish make. And he was confounded because he knew that he had found him. But right now it was still for the fun, just a way to kill the time when the farming was done. Then the walking turned to running, and the hopping turned to jumping and dunking. And Russell had to keep coming because the youngin' was fucking disgusting and loving and running it. All of a sudden the public started to come in abundance and fuck with him because he was butter and hungry, hungry
customers.
Now normally for people like him, then the word got around up to ESPN, and they flying Russell down to compete in the gym. Bunch of grown men looking to belittle the kid, because to those men, ball was the reason to live. And the goats, they've been all in since they was kids. So this goat on the motherfucker look like a dick. And even though Russell knows that, he doesn't submit. He just chills with a grin. And then the game start, and this motherfucker take charge, make it rain hard. D up on these bitches, making children of men, looking better than his predecessors ever could get. Turn the animosity to respect. And then the Thunder called him, said they heard a lot about the ballin', told him that they wanna get involved in, showed him all the shit that you can get up in the league. It's so appalling. Oklahoma City in the autumn, hella pretty awesome.
Everybody laud him. Every bitty looking like they're really
fucking falling. Condominium is so legitimate, it's sprawling. And this motherfucker on the court straight ballin'. Cash all up in that ass, lolling at the pass like, where the fuck would I be at up on the other path, right? If I never stumble upon the game and think of that life. Shit. Who taking care of my farm? Who taking care of my farm?
Taking care of my farm.
Taking care of my farm.
Taking care of my farm.
I really love that farm.
Cake. 500 million, now that's a pound cake, according to Jay-Z and Drake. But greatness ain't about cake.
Woo. Woo. Yeah. Yo, guys, that was Lil Dicky's Russell Westbrook on a farm. Oh, my God. Listen, I always like Lil Dicky. You guys know I've heard a few songs here and there, checked out a few of his freestyles. But damn, this was like an actual fucking song. Nothing comedy around it. It's just him spitting, man. Lil Dicky, man, much respect to you, man. He's doing his fucking thing. Guys, I want to see flames down below. Flame emojis all in the comments, because that shit was dope as fuck. Thank you for whoever, quite a few guys actually requested this song, so thank you guys. Damn, that song was so dope. It's a little bit long, but it was fucking dope as hell, guys. Don't forget to slap that like button, guys. Also, if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, become part of the family. With that said, guys, I'll see you guys next time with another one. Bow!